Dozier. It's time to get to a championship. Second year for head coach Eddie Robinson Jr. We expect some big things.
Man, and this almost looks like a whole new team. I mean, you got a lot of transfers and key positions. Again, quarterback being the most important. Talk about a little bit about how the transfer portal has helped kind of remake this team this year.
Well, the transfer portal gives and it takes, always, as we always know. But I think we've benefited from it, like I said, adding guys in the SWAC. Andrew Boddy, great quarterback. Rico Dozier was an all SWAC team last year. And, you know, we're retooling instead of having to rebuild and bringing in high school freshmen. Obviously, you still want those freshmen, but you want those guys that are ready to go and ready to play right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, again, he threw for over 4,000 yards at Texas Southern last year.
Yep.
So you're getting a ready-made quarterback, threw for 48 touchdowns. You're getting a ready-made star quarterback in this position that can really help stretch. And I know that's what coach is looking for this year. What's been the tenor, the mood of this team this year?
Championship. It's almost championship or bust. You know, I think you finally have peace. You have enough upperclassmen. Obviously, one of the things we want to improve on is our offense, but having a new quarterback, having him come in, we have some young receivers. We're led by Tyree Saunders, a senior who's been here for 3 years. So we're looking forward to a championship. That's been always been the goal from year one for Coach Robinson. So I'm excited to see what happens.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, man, we've got literally perfect weather. You can't pray for perfect weather. For better weather out here today, it is, the atmosphere is great, the weather is great, the mood is great, everybody's feeling good, stands are starting to fill up. Man, how excited are you to see this spring game happen?
Football. It's football is football. You know, football is king in the South. Anytime you get a chance to see football in spring, especially since we haven't played since November, late October, I'm excited to see some football. That's the main thing. We want to see some great ball. Excited to see this team, the new additions, and I think alum are excited. And you said the atmosphere, a little bit windy. We would like the wind to go down, but it's a great atmosphere. I'm excited.
Yeah, absolutely. It'll be fun to see Boddy's, you know, his big arm kind of slicing through that wind right a little bit later on today, which has kind of died down here and there. But again, we want to kind of even just show you the atmosphere here a little bit and what's going on. You're looking at us right now, but here in a second, we're going to switch on over to just all the things that are happening. We've got vendors out here. We've got arcade games for the kids, carnival games. We've had some performances this morning from Fear Factor and some of the others, which was absolutely phenomenal. And in addition to that, again, it's SGA season, so everybody's got their booths out at Gate D. Talk about the culture here. As a student at Alabama State University, what's it like being here in this atmosphere?
So Alabama State's been in my blood since I was born. My parents were here. I'm a generational student. So it's exciting to be here. The alums really love and support this team. And we want to see some championships. That's the main thing. We want to see some great football. We want football and see some championships. Like you said, SGA elections going on. It's also probate season coming up next. We have a probate. So it's a great atmosphere to be out here. A lot of alums out here, a lot of great ball. And I'm excited to see the atmosphere.
Yeah, now, with the university, you got something called Days of Giving, which is super important to the school. Talk about that a little bit, what Days of Giving is.
So Days of Giving, you get the opportunity to give to your specific department. We have Athletics Days of Giving on April 9th through the 10th, or April 8th through the 9th, can't think of it. But we get the opportunity to give back to these departments and really invest in their future. So that's the most important thing for the school.
Yeah, and with athletics specifically, talk about the need for funds here to make sure that you guys are able to accomplish everything you want.
Well, you see where you are right now. We're in a great stadium. Our great stadium has been invested in. You know, we have NIL, something that's very important now. So if you can keep athletes here, you want to keep improving the facilities. It's all about investing in this program and believing in it. And winning championships helps out a lot.
Yeah, and I know Adidas is a big contribution to that and that partnership. What's it like being able to don the three stripes?
It's amazing. I mean, you see me right now, my Adidas on. I'm excited. I love it. Got my Adidas shoes on. Adidas has done great for this school, and looking forward to the future with them.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've got even a commercial for Days of Giving that goes on to illustrate the importance of it, how you can give. But if you want to give specifically to the athletics department here at Alabama State, you can visit their website /giving. It's alasu.edu/giving, and make sure that you're charitable to the alma mater. And even if you're not a graduate here of Alabama State University, just to have it here in our backyard. I mean, look at this beautiful stadium, the uniforms, the black and gold. My father was an alum here, and so I feel an immense amount of pride over just everything that we've got happening here. I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. So again, if you want to give, go to the website alasu.edu/giving. And there you'll be able to contribute.
calling all Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience.
Back. Now, again, new look football team in some respects this year. I want you to kind of talk about what Coach Robson has brought to this team.
He's brought toughness. He's a Hall of Fame swag, Hall of Fame player. He knows the school. He was on the national championship team in 1991, and the winning mentality. You know, back-to-back winning seasons—the first time since 2016 that we had this winning season. So he's a winner, and we want to keep adding on his third year, and hopefully, like I said, swag championship, Celebration Bowl. Those are big aspirations, but it's very much possible for this team.
No, it's absolutely possible. And to that effect, when we talk about the transfer portal, one of the best ways to get the culture of a team together is through those freshman players to really teach them and grow them and groom them into the players you want. They've got prospect camp coming up June 15th. Talk about that a little bit as an opportunity for young high school students to come on in, experience it, show what they've got to Coach Robinson and the coaching staff. What's it like when prospect camp is going on?
It's a great time. As you see, we have a lot of recruits here right now. I think it's about 100 that are in the stadium in attendance. And, you know, Coach Robinson is very big about getting the in-state guys and also, you know, hitting the South. He's from Louisiana, so he tries to get there as well. So it's very important to get those recruits in, because if you can get those guys here, because Coach Robinson was a walk-on. Wow. He's a walk-on, and he had a historic college career. So he knows the importance of recruiting high school students and developing them.
That's amazing. I actually went to prospect camp when I was in high school as a young defensive end. So I know. Now, Coach Robinson wasn't here, but I know first and foremost what it's like on this field, on the previous field, to be out here and to play. And it's an amazing opportunity just to get the instruction from the coaches. So I know every student athlete, the 100 recruits we got down here, are looking forward to that. Also, a little bit later on in the month, again, June 18th, they're having the 7-on-7 camp, yep. And that's a fun environment where they can let that ball fly, make some big plays, see where the quarterbacks and receivers are, some quarterbacks, some safeties, but also, again, man, get a good look at these recruits. What's a recruiting class looking like so far?
Recruit class looking exciting. Obviously, we don't have everybody on campus right now. Some of them came in, Zach Sims, who we'll see play today. We have some guys coming in the summer, Ashton Ashford, a couple of guys of that class. So it's exciting to see how they're going to come in and develop. If they'll get playing time right away. Also, we got some freshmen on the team right now, Jalen Jones, Ajay Harrell, getting an opportunity to really display their talents because they didn't get much playing time last year, redshirting. So got a great combination of upper class talent and younger talent.
Now, again, owed to myself as a former defensive end, Big Man Camp is June 18th as well. And that's an opportunity to get a great look at the O-line, D-line, even maybe some linebackers who play nickel, some hybrid players. Talk about that a little bit. The big men on campus who really, again, make the team in the trenches. What's it like? What are we looking forward to? What are some areas of need maybe even for the team this year along the trenches?
One of the things that Coach Robinson always talk about is having those guys up front. You know, you always need the guys up front. The game is won in the trenches. And Coach Robinson is someone who likes to run the football. Yeah. And in order to run the football, you got to have the guys up front to protect your running backs, protect your quarterbacks. I'm excited to see how many guys we can add over the transfer portal, because the transfer portal is still a well and alive. So we'll get an opportunity to bring those guys in and add to his roster. And like I said, get to the SWAC championship.
Yeah, and it's great to have the transfer portal specifically in those trenches positions, because, again, you know, a lot of times some guys may even hit their growth spurt a little bit late. I was one of those kids. So it's great to be able to look at.
You still play right now.
Hey, look, hey, Coach Robinson, I know you see this. I'm not hard to find. Hit me up. But, no, to that effect, again, a lot of times, sometimes they're late bloomers. So you can get a kid who was refined at a JUCO or even another HBCU or a Power 5, a D1 school, 2-3 years in the program, and they can come here ready-made. So that's what's really neat. So, again, I mean, it's great with the prospect camp, 707, Big Men on Campus. They'll have another prospect camp in July, I believe July 20th. So, again, if you are a young athlete out here, if you're a parent of an athlete watching this, man, make sure that you visit their website, Alabama State University's website, their athletic website, because you definitely want to be a part of those camps that they have going on. Because, again, they're amazing opportunities. I'm a witness of that as being somebody who's done them firsthand. Man, talk about the atmosphere that's here that's different from maybe your traditional Power 5, maybe PWI. How's Alabama State University as HBCU? How is it different?
Well, if I'm honest, I'm a graduating senior, so I've been here all years. One of the things that I experienced when I first got here was a culture shock.
Yeah.
Because I came from a predominantly white, you know, side of town. So coming here and really getting the experience of the Greeks, getting the opportunity to see, you know, all the other organizations you have on campus, SGA, it's nothing like it.
Yeah.
Alabama State is one of, if not, I'll say the best HBCU in the state for sure. No shout out to A&M. You know, we're the Hornets here. We love our Hornets. But HBCUs are great. I love the experience here, and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world.
Yeah. Now, you guys, switching back a little bit to sports, Orange Blossom Classic. Lot of excitement around that.
Absolutely.
Even in fact, we got a booth right here to my right, your left. Talk about the excitement around the Orange Blossom Classic.
Well, it's our first time going there. We play in a lot of classics every year, but this one is specifically replacing the Labor Day Classic for this year. So getting the opportunity to play North Carolina Central, a team that has been in the Celebration Bowl in recent years, seeing a competitive school early in the season, getting to see where you match up early in the season against a MEAC school who you could potentially see in the Celebration Bowl.
Yeah.
So getting that early season, you know, almost like boxing. Okay, let's see what we can do. It's a good opportunity, and I'm excited to go to Miami. I'm excited.
I know you are. Look, I'm a sneak on the cargo part of the plane, so I can go to Miami too. It's going to be beautiful. I mean, like weather like we've got here, but you can't beat the setting of Miami, and it'll be an amazing opportunity again for them to get a litmus test. Hey, where are we? Where are we punching at? Do we need to work on offense? Do we need to work on defense? We're building on that here, but you'll be able to build on that even more in the Orange Blossom Classic.
And also, it's an opportunity for this game will be on ESPN. And you're going to be one of the only – it's on a Sunday. You're getting an opportunity to be the only thing on TV because NFL won't be started yet. There's an opportunity for seniors, freshmen, make your name for the national scouts. There's going to be scouts watching this game.
Yeah.
It's your opportunity to show yourself.
That is a great point that you brought up, man. Talk about the exposure that Alabama State specifically, but HBCUs are getting now in the past few years and how it's helping the programs, helping name recognition, even helping funding.
Now, it really does help when you have a coach like Eddie Robinson Jr. who played 10, 11 years in the NFL.
Yeah.
So he knows the track record. We have a track record of putting NFL guys in the air at least every single year. Keenan Isaac's most recent draft pick. We have Mikey Victor, who's projected to be one of the top corners in this class. Titus Howard, like I said, Coach Robinson, Reggie Barlow. We have, if any HBCU has track record of putting NFL players in the league, we got it.
Absolutely. And, man, we're excited because, again, you guys have got some absolute ballers who could – potentially be in the pros maybe next year, as early as next year. So I'm looking forward to what this team looks like, how it evolves.
I'm getting chills right now by the music.
I was about to say, you can hear the We Ready chants. So we're literally just around the corner from the start of this spring game. If I'll ask you, Khalil, one thing that you're looking for this year as an improvement, as an upgrade, what's something that you're excited to see?
I'm excited to see the quarterback play. I'll keep talking about Andrew Body. Andrew Body was somebody I've been watching since he was a freshman. His family is here. They showed us some love. I'm excited to see how they look at the offense because the offense is something that, you know, it's been up and down for the past couple of years. We want to see an explosive offense and a growing offense. Improve. We have new offensive coordinators, a new look, offensive line, new receiver coach, brand new offensive staff. So seeing how their game plan implements, it's going to be exciting.
Absolutely. Again, when we come back, because we're going to close here soon, but we're going to talk about this atmosphere that we've got. We're going to even show you a little bit of the atmosphere, what's going on as we start to pivot towards the game. But look, man, it is black and gold spring game. The atmosphere is here. The players are getting ready. You don't want to miss it. Thank you all for tuning in. And it's not too late. If you can, come
get
on
out here.
Down. Get out here because, yep. Look, you're going to be mad if you miss it. Trust me.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture. You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today, you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience.
A first-class institution.
Together we are swarm as one.
In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seat and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
Every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture. You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience. A first-class institution.
Together we are swarm as one.
Chris and Khalil, we're back here at the Black and Gold game. We're excited. Now, one of the interesting things about today is football is the only team that's here right now. We're going to get into a little bit of why here in a second, but we want to revisit Day of Giving because that's just something that's so important, man. We are blessed, for many of us that are blessed, to have a little bit to give, a little bit extra to give, and there's no better cause in the nation than giving to the Black and Gold. Alabama State University, again, for athletics specifically, it is the 8th and the 9th of this month, so literally right around the corner. Talk about, again, from somebody who works in athletics, who's a graduate here of Alabama State University, still here, still working, contributing. Why is it important that we give?
You need it. I mean, it's ultimately needed for facilities, athletes. You know, one of the things being at HBCU, you don't have the same amount of money as a PWI. So you have to be able to compete NIL-wise. You know, you want these big-time recruits from these high schools. If you want to compete, you got to have those guys. Because NIL money is important. You know, you got places like Texas, Alabama. We're in a very competitive football state. And if you want to compete football-wise or any sport, you got to have NIL money. We want to keep to improve this beautiful Hornet Stadium.
Yeah, absolutely. And when it comes to charitable giving. Again, if you want to give, you can visit their website, alasu.edu/giving. And there you'll find out more information about the ways that you can give and ways that you can contribute. Now, when we talk about the teams being here, football's here. They're ready to put on a show. But where's everybody else at?
Everybody else in Tallahassee right now. They're FAMU, tennis team, baseball team, softball team. It's ironic it all fell in one weekend. But our baseball team is competing right now. They just lost yesterday to FAMU 10-2, but she has two more games today to win the series. Softball got a big win against FAMU yesterday. Number two team in the SWAC. Softball is a great competitive team. Tennis, our men's tennis team, actually just won the regular season SWAC championship. So we're excited, and it's a great look right now. Hopefully they come out with the wins.
That's amazing. And what's the environment around just athletics in whole? Where are the teams at? Where are we feeling? How are we feeling about it?
Well, actually, our bowling team just won the SWAC championship. They were at the NCAA tournament. They lost in the first round, unfortunately. But to win the SWAC championship, it's a great feel. Getting an opportunity to go to Dallas, Texas to compete in the bowling NCAA tournament, it was a great feel. Baseball, softball, like I said, we're hoping that they can come back and win the SWAC championship, compete. Long season ahead. Senior day is coming up for softball. Senior day is coming up for baseball in May. And we're excited to see that.
Now, we've got something that is going to happen that is incredibly, incredibly rare. And that is a women's flag football game that's going to be televised, man. Yep. Talk about that, how rare that is, how excited everybody is for it. Let us know what are we looking forward to with this.
Well, the first thing I want to say is we're the first SDU to have it. We number one. It's always important to be number one. We're aware history is made at Alabama State University, and we definitely made history adding women's flag football. Women's flag football is something that has been on the cusp, especially last year in Alabama high schools. They've added more, and we're looking to add on to it, hopefully get a couple recruits. I think they have meetings this upcoming week, an interest meeting for all the women who want to join the team. So it's exciting. I'm looking forward to it. It's something new, and, you know, hopefully – the other schools around HBCU continue to add, and we can have a SWAC conference, yeah. Women's League.
They might be giving the men a run for their money. I don't know.
For sure.
I don't know. They look serious out here.
Women, we got some talented, as I always say, women run this campus right now as far as championships.
I believe it. And when we talk about the overall excitement that's bringing, again, you can kind of see the atmosphere. So, again, we got Orange Blossom here. Over there, we've got the ball pit here, which we're going to show you here in a second. We've got some vendors that you can get some drinks, some snow cones, some ice cream, the whole nine. So, again, this is not just a game. It's not just a scrimmage. This is an event.
But this is how HBCUs are. It's never – when you go to a football game, basketball game, you're never coming – you're coming to either watch the band. Yeah, the game is nice, but we want to see our – we want to reunite with our former colleagues, our kids, family. It's like every day is a cookout, almost.
Man, you said something with that. Family. I mean, you're going to be greeted with smiles no matter where you go, where you're at on campus, where you're at in the stadium. It is a big family atmosphere.
Absolutely. One of the things that we're big on is Common University. We want to get out in the community, give back to the community, because we're Montgomery's Division I program. We are, you know, with not having a professional team, we are that professional team. And we want to be the standout. We want to represent the city of Montgomery as best as we can.
Yeah. And speaking of that, we're going to go ahead and pan over there here just to show this ball pit, this ball game, some of the kids hanging out, having fun, the atmosphere just a little bit. Look, we're going to be here. We're not going anywhere. We're going to pan over to that. Let you enjoy this atmosphere, soak up a little bit of what's happening today right before we see the game that we are all waiting for. Man, I'm so excited. Coach Robinson and the Black and Gold are going to take that field here in just a little bit. Looking forward to it. We'll see you when we come back.
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Lou. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your ticket. Get ready for the
All Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience.
A first-class institution.
Together we are swarm as one.
We are back. I'm Chris, this is Khalil, and we're here with the unmatched Miss Jasmine Carr, who is an Alabama State University alum, actually used to be the equipment manager for the team during her days here, and is now doing amazing things in Atlanta, Georgia, but stays connected to the team through so many different ways, including her giving. But I want to just kind of hear some of her story and why Alabama State University made such an impact on her that you've never lost the connection here. What was it like as a student here at the Alabama State?
I'm a very proud alumni. I graduated in 2009, and I was an equipment manager, so now I'm a part of our Football Alumni Association, which is a nonprofit that works in our athletic program here. It's called FIB. We give back to the athletics. But being a student here was one of the best decisions that I ever made, coming to Alabama State. I really enjoyed being a part of the community here. Working in the athletic department gave me so many different opportunities. I knew that I wanted to work in sports when I was in school, but I didn't know how to get into sports. But our football coaches, baseball coaches, and basketball coaches gave me the opportunity to do internships while I was in school. So that really opened up the door for me. My first job straight out of school was working for the NBA and WNBA in Minnesota. And I did that and realized it actually was not for me, but it really opened a lot of doors and gave me a lot of opportunities. And I realized that's something that I wanted to do more as a passion versus a career path. So I still work in sports. I actually run a nonprofit for Tavares Jackson, who passed away in 2020, but did play in the NFL. He was the quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings as well as the Seahawks. And he ran a free camp here in Montgomery, Alabama, which is his home. So we still run the camp for him every year at Alabama State, which sponsors us along with the Seahawks. And we run a free camp every year behind that. And so that's just something that I love about Alabama State, because they support their own Hornets, really support each other. And I just love that about us.
That's amazing. And I've got a question for you, then I'll pass it to Khalil. You're an equipment manager, so you know how much goes into just game day and practices. A lot of people might just think, oh, you know, they got the uniforms, the cleats, that's it. You know, so how much do they really need? But you being intimately acquainted with everything that goes into it, talk about the need for giving for the supplies, for uniforms, for mouthpieces, for socks, just everything.
Yes, it is a lot of work that goes into being an equipment manager. There's so much that goes on behind the scenes that people don't know about. I really actually fought to become a part of our Football Alumni Association. I'm the first woman that's a part of our Football Alumni Association, because behind the scenes, it's everything. There's not just a helmet, but if a helmet, when they're on the field, if they get hit, if one of those screws are loose, that makes or breaks if they can the type of head injury they can get. So we have to make sure that the helmet is the right type of helmet that they're wearing, that all the screws are tight, they have all of their mouthpieces like you talked about, the knee pads, the right type of shoulder pads they have, that their uniforms are clean, that they look really good on the field. And we're also setting up for practices every day. So just like they have blood, sweat, and tears before every game, so do we. And we're setting up and breaking down the field every day. So it takes a lot that goes into it. And we really, you really have to love the sport and have a lot of dedication. But it's also a scholarship. A lot of people don't know about it. It's a partial scholarship. So it helped pay for me to go to school, pay for my education. So.
That's amazing. Yeah. And there's a lot of work, but there's also a lot of giving and a lot of funds that are needed to be able to buy all of that.
It is, yeah. So, you know, athletics, and, you know, it's also a career path that a lot of people don't know about. When it comes to athletics, part of FIB, what we do is also mentor our athletes to talk about what beyond the field. Like, a lot of people think that you come and you play a sport for these athletes, and then the only option is to become an NFL player or to become an NBA player. But what about if you're not one of those, that 1% that is able to make it to do that? What are the other options? You can become, you know, you can become the equipment manager, or you can become a different type of manager. You can go into sales, you can go into marketing, or you can become a broadcaster. And we talk to them about the other options that there are. So when you get into this industry, you're able to learn a lot more. And somebody like me that has worked in sports in so many different aspects, I'm able to talk to those athletes about that. And that's what that door opened up for me.
That's amazing.
Yes.
You mentioned Tavares Jackson. Talk about the impact that he's had on this football team and on the Football Alumni Association.
Yeah, so Tavares' impact, I think, is something that really is unmeasurable, because he would walk into a room and he just – I mean, I feel like it's very cliche to say that, you know, he just lit up the room, but he really did, because you would meet him and – he made you feel like family, and that's what it was for a lot of people. He was a senior my freshman year, so I really didn't get to know him a lot while we were in school together. However, my first job, like I said, was with the Minnesota Timberwolves and Lynx. So when I moved to Minnesota, he was the only person that I knew there. And because we had that connection of Alabama State, and we all know if anybody that went to an HBCU, it's not like when you go to a PWI, but everybody is family. So when I moved there, he really took me under his wing. He introduced me to people. He showed me around, and we really had a connection. We really became best friends when we lived there. So I was able to live there in Minnesota with him for a few years, and he taught me a lot of things, and we were able to work together. So essentially, I kind of became his manager while working there, and he had a large impact on me because he taught me a lot about sports and managing athletes and taught me how to navigate that field. And what his impact was here in Montgomery was that he really knew what it meant to give back to his home. He knew what it meant that just because he had, that didn't mean that he had to leave behind the other people that didn't have things. So when he came back home, he really wanted to give back to his community. And his free camp, that's what it was about. It was about giving back to others that didn't have. And he would do a lot of other philanthropy things, like doing school drives when it came to tennis shoes or uniforms and things like that. And he grew up in a single parent household, so he did a lot with single mothers. And he would also go and talk to students about not just football things, but the importance of education. So that was something that was really close and dear to his heart. So what we're doing with his nonprofit, the Tavares Jackson Legacy Foundation, is just talking about his legacy and what it meant to him to be able to give back to community.
Now, when you were an equipment manager at Alabama State, did you realize, you know, one thing is that we just had Women's History Month in sports. How great does it make you feel to see women in sports nowadays?
I think women in sports is great. I worked as an equipment manager, and I did that because I'm athletically challenged. I cannot play a sport to save my life, but I really did enjoy sports. But I think it's very important to see a lot more women step up in sports, or lots of different areas. Like, I love that here at Alabama State, we're starting the first HBCU women's flag football team. I think that says a lot about what we can do in different fields, especially in HBCU world. But I'm loving to see, you know, with all these different we're seeing some of the first women equipment managers in the NFL. We're seeing first women referees in lots of different sports. And I think that's just very impactful and powerful. And I think that women can do anything that we strive to do, not necessarily that men can do, because I don't know if I necessarily believe that necessarily. But I think that anything that we want to do, that we're able to achieve that. And I think it's very powerful.
One last question, I'll pass it back over to you. What is your excitement about this year's football team? Obviously, you have the Orange Blossom Classic. We have all the Magic Classics. We have a bunch of classes this year.
Yeah.
So what is your excitement around this year's team? I was there on the field now. How do you feel about this year's team?
I'm excited every year for our football team, and I'm hopeful that this year is better than last year. I think that each year we just want to be better than we were the year before. I'm really excited about the Orange Blossom Classic. I think it's really exciting that we get to go to Florida. I hope that we have a lot of students that travel to be able to go to this game. And I'm just really excited to see what our team can go out here and do. I hope that we are able to bring home a championship this year. And, you know, I'm just really excited to see what our team is able to do. I'm excited for the new recruits that we have coming in this year, and I hope they have the same passion for our football team that we do.
And you give not just your time and your energy and excitement and driving down here from Atlanta, unless you flew, but you also give your money as well. Why is that important to you?
Yeah, I think I drove down here and I came down here just for the day. I think it's really important to give back to your university, because if we don't give back, who else will? You know, it's really important to show not only with your time, but with your money, that you care about something, because we have to invest in our university. We have to show that we care with that time and with the money that because our institutions need us. And that's the only way that we can.
And so as a reminder, this is Days of Giving. It's going to be the 8th and the 9th of this month. If you want to give specifically to athletics, and look, we encourage everyone that's watching, if you would please do that, help make an impact on the greatest university in the country. I'm Chris, this is Khalil and Jasmine. We've got a lot more interviews coming up for you, so make sure you stay tuned. We'll see you on the other side.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience.
A first-class institution.
Together we are swarm as one.
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Lou. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your tickets.
But for me, I think my reason for giving to Alabama State, and I think other people will probably see the same way, I think you have that question of, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And so I can truly answer that to say, coming here as an 18-year-old freshman football player, having never been to the city of Montgomery, Alabama State has done so much for me. The people around campus, Coach Markham, all of my teachers, professors, have really helped me out as a person and developing to the man I am today. And so truly, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And we want the next generation of kids to be able to answer that same question. And we have to give back so we can help them to say, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be?
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience. A first-class institution.
Together we are Swarm as one.
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Lou. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your tickets.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket,
every touchdown,
every goal,
and every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience, a first-class institution.
Together, we are Swarm as one.
Think he did when he packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everything I wanted, man, it seems so serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you were a champion? When it feel like living's harder than dying. For me, giving up's way harder than trying. Lauryn Hill said her heart was in Zion. I wish her heart still was in rhyming. Kids gonna listen to, huh? I guess me if it isn't you.
But for me, I think my reason for giving to Alabama State, and I think other people will probably see the same way. I think you have that question of, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And so I can truly answer that to say, coming here as an 18-year-old freshman football player, having never been to the city of Montgomery, Alabama State has done so much for me. The people around campus, Coach Markham, all of my teachers, professors have really helped me out as a person and developing to the man I am today. And so truly, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And we want the next generation of kids to be able to answer that same question. And we have to give back so we can help them to say, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be?
Get ready for the Colliding HBCU Showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back Labor Day weekend at the Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. The top 10 HBCU matchup, the North Carolina Central University Eagles and the Alabama State University Hornets. Don't miss the electrifying halftime performance and the other week-long events. Tickets on sale now at orangeblossomclassic.com.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience, a first-class institution.
Together, we are Swarm as one.
My appeal, walk through clouds.
We got some grit still there, so I'm excited.
Now, when you bring in these new teams each and every year, how are you able to get the feel for, okay, I can coach this team this way, I can coach this team in different ways each and every year?
I think once you establish a culture, and I think it's all about culture, and you'll figure out whether or not they're a good fit or not. But once we establish the culture, especially starting over, establishing a culture and a mindset, that's when you know. So it's all about the culture.
Yeah, and with talking about transfers coming in, how has kind of the transfer portal, how has that changed your coaching style?
Oh, my gosh. The transfer portal is transformational. I think it creates a lot more equity and more parity across the board in us playing Power Fives. I brought in three trans come here. One, they feel loved. Two, they feel like they're at home. And three, they know I'm going to take my time and truly coach them up.
Yeah. And talk about, to your point, the feel of being at home. How is the culture here so different? How does that help you in recruiting?
I think the thing about all HBCUs, we are the place where our kids know they can come home. They can make mistakes and we gonna love them through it. And we know they're young and they're gonna make mistakes. But I think that's what Old Mother Dear does, is that we say, hey, we're here to grow you. We want you to fail forward, because failure is the beginning step of success. So we don't give them a bad nod or push them away. And when I say failure, I just might mean they might make a mistake and go out to a kickback when they shouldn't have. They might have made a mistake and didn't get homework done. That's all in growth. So I think right here the difference is I'm going to allow them room to grow. There may be some ramifications, but I'm going to love them through it.
This year's Hornet volleyball team, what's our expectations? What are we doing? What are we looking for? What are we achieving this year?
Well, we always expect to win. We were undefeated last year in regular season, crowned regular season champs alone. The year before, we went 15-1, co-champions. There's a tradition here of winning. So we're going to find a way to make one. That's not being boastful. That's not being arrogant. That's calling those things that be not as though they were. That's saying, I believe. That's saying, this is what we're about. We're going to find a way to make one.
That's a great way to put it. Now, one of the things that we're adding is a women's flag football team. And you are someone who is a big advocate about women in sports. Talk about the excitement behind that.
I think when I saw it, I got very excited. One, because right now, it's all about the woman. We looking at the Final Four. I bet this the first time you can call out five NCAA basketball players by name.
Absolutely.
It is the time of the woman. Just before our season, we played on the national field at the University of Nebraska. We talking about the woman. For the first time, we're able to show the value that women brings to sports. And I'm so excited that Dr. Cable felt it was important enough for us to start the program here. So we are the cutting edge of change. That's why I love being here.
Now, talk about one of the things you are big on, as you just said, was your legacy. You're a winner. What do you want your legacy to be once you're done coaching?
Once I'm done coaching, every woman that have ever stepped foot on this ground and graduated will tell you they were winners on the court. But the biggest thing they're going to tell you is that we taught them how to be winners in life. Why? Because we prepared them for corporate America. They will know that not only did they earn the seat at the table, they are qualified to sit at the table. Their voice matters, and they add value wherever they are in whatever industry they're in.
That's beautiful. And finally, Days of Giving is this month, April 8th and 9th for athletics. Talk about the need for those that are alums, but even just people who enjoy the product, come out to games that'll be here today, why it's so important for them to contribute to athletics here at Alabama State.
Guys, I can humbly say, we know we keep our gym full, but you, if you've been in my gym, you know the need of, what do you call it, upgrading. We want to ask you to please come out and give to ASU Athletics. And then I want you to market volleyball. But we're going to always put out a great product. It's a great time to be a Hornet.
How long, how many years have you put into coaching volleyball here at Alabama State University?
I've been here 13 seasons. I'm going into my 14th season.
What keeps you going?
This is my passion. This is easy.
Well, that's amazing. We're so glad to have talked with you. This has been wonderful. I know we're going to have some more interviews coming up, including our next interview with the athletic director here at The Alabama State University. I'm Chris. This is Khalil. We look forward to seeing you on the other side.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket,
every touchdown,
every goal,
and every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience, a first-class institution.
Together, we are swarm as one.
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Luke. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your tickets.
I think he did when he packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everything I wanted, man, it seems so serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you were a champion? When it feel like living's harder than dying. For me, giving up's way harder than trying. Lauryn Hill said her heart was in Zion. I wish her heart still was in rhyming. Kids gonna listen to, huh? I guess me if
calling all Hornet.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket,
every touchdown,
every goal,
and every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today, you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience. A first-class institution.
Together, we are swarm as one.
And we are back. I'm Chris. This is Khalil. And we're here with a very familiar face for Hornet Nation, Dr. Jason Campbell, the athletic director here at Alabama State University. Thank you so much for joining us, Dr. Campbell. Now, this is a beautiful atmosphere, second to none. It's a black and gold game here. We get a first look at this year's Hornet football team. Talk about the atmosphere first before we get into what's going to happen on the field.
Well, here at Alabama State, when you look at our football complex and what we do and where we're situated, it's a community event. So it's more than a game. We had an opportunity to have Fan Fest earlier today. Invited out numerous groups, a lot of young Hornets. Get an opportunity to see what we have to offer as relates to facility, and we look to grow them to future Hornets.
Yeah, and speaking of that future Hornets, you got about 100 recruits down on the field. Obviously, the players are down there warming up. What are you looking forward to most today with the spring game?
This is a game you can't lose. So I told Coach Robinson, you know, after this game, we'll still be undefeated before the season. So more importantly, you just want to see crisp, clean football discipline. And we just hope that we can build on this going toward our first game as we travel to participate in the Orange Blossom Classic in Miami, Florida. But most importantly, we don't want anyone to get hurt.
Now, talk about adding the Orange Blossom Classic to this year's schedule in Miami. Talk about the experience and what you're expecting.
Well, I think it's going to be a great experience for our fans, for Hornets and Eagles. We play North Carolina Central. But additionally, we have an opportunity to bring HBCU culture to South Florida. And as you know, it's rich with talent, athletic talent, and academic talent. And so we get an opportunity to infiltrate South Florida and show the best of Alabama State. And that's what we want to do. And we need all our fans and supporters to come to Miami. I don't know anybody that would turn down a trip to Miami during Labor Day. So you need to be there.
And it's also an opportunity for you to see a team that you may see down the road in the Celebration Bowl.
Absolutely. North Carolina Central over the last couple of years have been a nationally ranked program. And so they've been in the top 25. And if you look at the beginning of our schedule, we have North Carolina Central and then we have Samford. Both of those programs traditionally are in the top 25. So if we end those 2 weeks 2-0, then Alabama State has a great chance of being ranked in the nation. And we want to play a competitive schedule each and every year.
Now, switching gears just a little bit to talk about something that's super important for your department, which is Days of Giving. Mm-hmm. April 8th and 9th is where people can go to the website and give to the athletic department. Make a quick appeal. Why should they do that?
They should do that because it's our future. You're giving to a cause that's going to continue to grow and give back. So our students and student athletes need that support to help them as they leave Alabama State, get into their career, and they'll have an opportunity to do the same thing. So our Days of Giving is really rooted and grounded in the student and student-athlete experience, the things that we can provide here on campus that will help them get out in the workforce, have very productive careers. In athletics, we call it 4 for 40. 4 years on the campus of Alabama State University should prepare you for the next 40 years of your life. And we want to do that at a high level, and that's why you should give back during the Days of Giving on April 8th and 9th.
Now, last year we had a winning season. Coach Robinson put together back-to-back winning seasons. What is your expectation for this upcoming season?
The expectation Coach talks about, so it's just not my expectation. It's a shared expectation. We want to win the SWAC Championship, and we want to win the Celebration Bowl. So we're keenly focused on that, and it takes a lot. And even outside of the field of play, Coach Robinson has done a great job academically with our football student-athletes and also preparing them to be men. And so I really commend Coach Robinson for taking that mindset. It's not all about athletics, right? Although we want to win, we want to develop leaders.
Dr. Cable, thank you for spending the time with us. I know you're a busy man. We're going to let you get back to it. But there's so much more, including a number of different interviews coming on the other side of this break. But again, before we go, we want to tell you how you can give and contribute to Alabama State University. Make sure you go to their website, alasu.edu/giving. Their Days of Giving for Athletics are April 8th and 9th. Such an important cause. And again, we can enjoy collectively the amazing product that Alabama State puts out for us through all of their athletic programs. Thank you, and we'll see you on the other side.
Love is an action word. And what better way to show your love for Old Mother Dear than to give during the Days of Giving on April 8th and April 9th. Your gift to Alabama State University will impact the lives of our current Hornets and our future Hornets in a significant way.
Well, for me, I think my reason for giving to Alabama State, and I think other people will probably see the same way, I think you have that question of, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And so I can truly answer that to say, coming here as an 18-year-old freshman football player, having never been to the city of Montgomery, Alabama State has done so much for me. The people around campus, Coach Markham, all of my teachers, professors, have really helped me out as a person and developing to the man I am today. And so truly, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be? And we want the next generation of kids to be able to answer that same question. And we have to give back so we can help them to say, if not for Alabama State, then where would I be?
Yeah!
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Lou. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your tickets.
Think he did when he packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everything I wanted, man, it seems so serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you were a champion? When it feel like living's harder than dying, for me giving up's way harder than trying. Lauryn Hill said her heart was in Zion. I wish her heart still was in rhyming. Kids gonna listen to, huh? I guess me if it isn't you. Last week I paid it.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student athlete experience
by providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience. A first-class institution.
Together we are swarm as one.
Think he did when he packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everything I wanted, man, it seems so serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you were a champion? When it feel like living's harder than dying, for me giving up's way harder than trying. Lauryn Hill said her heart was in Zion. I wish her heart still was in rhyming. Cause who the kids gon' listen to? I guess me if it isn't you.
We are back. I'm Chris. This is Khalil. And this is Shannon Kloman. The game has started, and it is amazing. They are getting in some wonderful plays, some great reps. We're not going to bring it to you, though, because we don't want to give away too many of the trade secrets, the recipe for this coming up year. So we're going to continue some of the interviews that we've got going on. We've got Shannon Kloman, who's the president of the National Alumni Association, to talk about all they're doing, how they're involved with the university, and the importance for people to be a part and the importance for them to give. Thank you so much for joining us, Shannon. What's going on with the Alumni Association?
Oh, well, there's so much going on with the Alumni Association right now. We've just finished up two regional conferences. One for the Far West was in January, and then we have one that was in the Northeast area that happened in March. So right now we're getting ready for the Midwest, which will be in Chicago, and the Southeast region will be in Huntsville.
When it comes to the Alumni Association, what are some of the ways that you guys make former students, alumni, still feel a part of the university, still feel like family here at Alabama State?
So what we do is we try and encourage the graduating seniors to come and join us. And in joining us, what we do, we have it set up so that they're free for the first year. So those individuals, they don't have to do anything. All they have to do is just sign up. So we send them to the website, the BamaStateAlumni.org website. They can join that website. And in doing that, they just find the chapter that fits wherever they're going. So we don't lock them in. For example, you're going to be living in Montgomery, but you might find a job in Atlanta. But there's a chapter in Atlanta. So we try to make sure that there's a connection where they can go wherever the chapter is.
Now, we've got Shannon here with us, and he's answered some amazing questions. But I don't know if you can hear that or not, but that is the sound of the best band in the land, the Mighty Marching Hornets. We're going to go ahead and switch over to a camera angle, and we're just going to enjoy that for a second, if that's okay. Then we'll come back. The Mighty Marching Hornets are playing and singing and going awesome, going off.
Rule don't change. That's a Hornet version. Cole Somerville, number 35, on the tackle.
So talk about one of the things, being an alumni. Sometimes being an alumni is more important than the actual undergraduate experience. Talk about how you're able to give back to the school for the students and all the, it's that experience.
Yeah, the thing that I find is that when people first graduate, they're trying to get their own footing. So those individuals may not be able to give a lot of money immediately when they graduate. So we expect them to come out and volunteer for some of the events and activities wherever there's an opportunity. Those opportunities that are here on campus, as well as from some of these local chapters. Local chapters have scholarship events. They have events where they're doing recruitment. So there are college fairs happening all over the country. So we expect those students to go out and volunteer. And then after they've gotten themselves some footing within the next 3 or 4 years, then they see where the importance is in terms of giving back. Now we have some people that want to give back directly to the university. We have others that want to give to their local chapter. So you have opportunities to give in several different capacities.
Now, talk to me as if I'm a high school student. What message would you give to me about coming to Alabama State University?
As a high school student, the thing that I try and tell people is, let's talk about what you're planning to do. If that's something that we offer, we want to encourage you to come to Alabama State, tell you about some of the avenues where you can do co-ops, internships, some of the companies that are coming in seeking students for that particular major. And if it's something that we don't offer, we try and see if there's some way we can bridge that gap. Sometimes we have programs with other universities that gives you the opportunity to actually stay at Alabama State for 2 or 3 years and then go somewhere else and get that degree that you're trying to achieve.
Now, your role as a president, talk about your day-to-day or what you're doing and what you're working in the association.
Yeah, day-to-day dealing with it as the National Alumni Association president, you're dealing with some of the things dealing with chapter administration, chapter logistics. You're doing a lot of planning. So you're working with the university in terms of some of the different offices. For example, working with the career services office in terms of an oratorical competition that we normally have during Founders Day. Well, what we do is we send something out through something that's on campus called Handshake. Well, once you send that information out, that's not necessarily something that the alumni would be able to see. So we work with that office in order to gather all the data. And then once they gather all that information, then we have alumni come in, review it, and then make a decision about who won that competition. So we try and work with the services and the systems that are already in place so that we're not working against one another.
So one of the slogans here is that it's a community. How does that help in bringing in alumni, retaining alumni, given the fact that there's such a community and a family feel here?
Well, the thing that I always think of is when we talk about a community is that there are opportunities for the alumni that have that work in different occupations to bring what they do back to the school. Right now, I know that there's someone that actually works at NIH. He's worked with the university in terms of trying to bring in some special guests in order to expose the community, not just the university, but the community to something that they're working on.
That's fantastic. And with that, engaging the former alumni, I would imagine that just makes you guys feel valued.
Oh, yes, most definitely. We always are amazed at some of the things that alumni come back and tell us that they've been able to do after they left Alabama State. And some of it is not even related to the degree that they achieved while they were here. They kind of roll into different things. So, yeah.
Now, with being a part, being engaged, there's coming to games, there's so many different things like the galas, the oratory competitions that you guys put on. But one of the most important ways that you can support the university is through giving.
Oh, yes.
We've got our Days of Giving going on, and the 8th and the 9th of this month, they can give specifically to athletics. Why is that something that people should do, especially alumni?
Well, I think the alumni should always give back. And when you're giving back this way, it's directed back to the athletic department, for example. Now, if you're giving directly to the athletic department, that means that you're giving an opportunity for some student, no matter where they come from, an opportunity to excel in that sport as well as in the classroom. And then you have to look at it holistically when you're dealing with the student because you don't know what their circumstances are. But you want them to be the best person possible once they leave.
That's amazing. And again, if you are someone who's an alumni, or even if you're just someone who enjoys Alabama State University as being a university here located in the capital city in Alabama, Montgomery, make sure that you visit their website, alasu.edu/giving. Again, that's alasu.edu/giving. And there you'll be able to give, again, the 8th and the 9th of this month. They go specifically towards athletics. So we look forward to seeing you contribute and be a part of this beautiful university. I'm Chris. This is Khalil. This is Shannon. Thanks, and we'll see you on the other side.
Calling all Hornets.
Hornet Nation.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today, you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience. A first-class institution.
Together, we are swarm as one.
Get ready for the ultimate HBCU showdown. The 2024 Denny's Orange Blossom Classic is back for its fourth year. Labor Day weekend in Miami Gardens at the Hard Rock Stadium. This is where community, culture, and HBCU pride collide. We brought you Coach Prime in 2021 with the live performances by Miami's own Trina and Uncle Lou. In 2022, we brought you Lettucey. And in 2023, we brought you Lloyd. 2024 will be a week of events that will make you not want to leave the city of Miami, baby. The top 10 HBCU matchup featuring the North Carolina Central University Eagles versus the Alabama State University Hornets. Experience the excitement of the halftime game with the electrifying performance from the NCCU Sound Machine and the ASU Mighty Marching Hornets. Upgrade your experience with our premium style seating and exclusive suites. The best way to watch the game come to life. Tickets are on sale right now. Visit orangeblossomclassic.com for more information and to get your tickets.
Alabama State alumni.
Parents and friends.
This message is for you.
Our athletics department has excelled in many ways.
Thanks to your generous giving and unwavering support.
But we're not finished.
Every basket.
Every touchdown.
Every goal.
And every championship we win propels us to push forward
in pursuit of a more dominant championship culture.
You are a vital part of the Hornets legacy.
And today you can make your tangible impact to our Athletics Day of Giving.
Your support enhances the student-athlete experience.
By providing resources for games, practice, travel, and championships.
In other words, your support through the Day of Giving
helps elevate our
experience at Alabama State University.
Join our pursuit of excellence on and off the field, on the court,
and in the classroom.
Join us today for our Athletics Day of Giving.
Thank you for all you do to give us first-class experience, a first-class institution.
Together, we are swarm as one.
We are back. I'm Chris. This is Khalil. And this is Miss Gwendolyn Bennett. And, man, there is such an amazing atmosphere here. The Mighty Marching Hornets just got done playing. And what I tell you, look, we're not giving away the secret sauce, the recipe. But, man, the boys look amazing today. Boy just threw an incredible laser up the right hash to number three for a touchdown. They're doing awesome. The game looks wonderful. I know Coach is pleased. We'll hear more from him a little bit later on today. But we want to talk about the Orange Blossom Classic that is coming up in none other than Miami, Florida.
Miami, Florida.
Ms. Bennett is here with us. Talk about this classic. How excited are you for it?
Wow. First, I just want to say thank you so much to Alabama State for allowing us to come here in the Hornet's Nest. Right? It's so amazing here. And we got the Orange Blossom Classic that's happening Labor Day weekend in September in the beautiful city of Miami, Florida. And we have Alabama State going up against North Carolina Central, and we're excited about that.
When it comes to the Orange Blossom Classic, what is it about Miami that's going to add an extra added layer to this game?
Wow. Wow. You talked about secret sauce. We have the secret sauce down in Miami. It is none other than probably one of the number one top travel destinations. You got the sand, you got the beach, you got the sun, you got some amazing vibes that are happening down there in South Florida. And we're just bringing everything.
Now talk about your role specifically with the Orange Blossom Classic.
Wow, so I have the pleasure of being the executive assistant for the executive director, Ms. Kendra Bullock, the brainchild of this whole thing of bringing the Orange Blossom Classic back to fruition, just the whole vibrancy of it. And I am like, I guess I'm there. I'm the right-hand man. I hear the secrets behind the scenes. So I'm excited about being a part of that, you know, just working with her and bringing this whole thing together.
Now, you've been on this campus for, I saw you yesterday. You've been on the move.
Yes.
Now, talk about how the alumni, the fans, the students have been welcoming to you.
Wow. So Alabama has been amazing. Just day one, Alabama State, the alumni have been welcoming. The students have been welcoming. Everybody is like, we're excited about coming to Miami. So I'm getting that Southern hospitality down here. So it's amazing.
So you got our hospitality. Yes. Have we swayed you a little bit? Are you rooting for us now? Did we get you?
Well, I got a big sweatshirt with a hornet on the back. I'm feeling it. I'm right now. I'm swaying.
We'll take that. Look, hey, you heard her. She said she swayed. When it comes to the game,
yes.
This is, again, the first time for Alabama State. What is it like having the game there in terms of, you know, charitable contribution, in terms of economic impact? What's it like being able to have a classic?
So having a classic in South Florida is huge. You know, like you said, the economic impact, how we're bringing so many jobs down there. We have our own Business Unite, Black Business Unite, where we would support all of our black business owners. And we have a roster. We use them just about for everything that we do. So when you talk about economic impact, it's fire. You know, people are coming from all over the country to the number one HBCU reunion. Okay, we're one big community. So everybody's excited about coming there so that they can showcase their talents, showcase their business. So when it's the infusion that we put into the community is very powerful.
And with that infusion into the community, being in South Florida, do you see the impact of that? Like, people are grateful that this
yes.
is happening. What's been the response to this?
The response has been, you know, first, they love the parade. I just want you to understand that. That's like a huge thing. But they love that it is bringing our culture there. They're excited about, you know, having HBCU there. You know, for a very long time, you know, I'm an alumni of Florida Memorial University, and we didn't have a football team. So to have a HBCU classic come down to South Florida is huge. You know, to have, you know, the last 3 years we had Jackson State and FAMU, you know, and just having that alumni base come down. And then when we switched it up and said Alabama State is coming, listen, the Hornets from everywhere is like, we need this, we want that. So it's good to have that have you all come down there, because you have a large alumni base there. So it was number one.
Now, talk about how this game has grown year to year.
Wow. So it has definitely done that. I can tell you the original was to come back in 2020. Of course, we had COVID. Okay, so that pushed it back to 2020. We had COVID. In 2021, when the game came in, everybody is like, we're in. We're outside, okay? So the numbers have been growing year by year. And we expect some amazing numbers coming out of Alabama. We've been at the Magic City Classic. So we're waiting for those RVs to pull up. We're waiting for all the black and gold. We're waiting for you guys to buzz in. That's it.
Absolutely. And if nothing else, State is going to show up
in
the building.
I hear that. Bama State is going to be in the building. I hear it.
Absolutely. Look, if people want to follow along, they want to learn more about the Orange Blossom Classic,
yes,
they want to reach out to you, what's a way they can do that?
Definitely. So, you guys, definitely you can go to our orangeblossomclassic.com. That's where you're going to find out about our suites. That's where you're going to find out about our tickets. That's where you're going to find out about the hotels. That's where you're going to find out about everything that you want, orangeblossomclassic.com. If you want to follow us on Instagram, Orange Blossom FC, okay? You can follow on Instagram, you can follow on Facebook, Orange Blossom Classic Football, Orange Blossom Football Classic, or on Facebook, Twitter, everything that you need, you can definitely, if you just start to put the ORA, it's going to come up.
It's going to pop up.
It's going to pop up.
Now, I'm going to take you back to the beginning,
yes,
and then I'm going to ask you this question, then we'll close. What has it been like being at the Alabama State University?
The vibe has been amazing. Like I said, from the fans, from the alumni, from the staff. It's just that hometown, that Southern hospitality has just been on fire for us, and we're just loving it. I mean, you got some powerhouse people there, and I have to shout out one person. Kiki Montgomery has been taking care of us day one, just holding our hands. I thank her so much. Colonel Clark has been taking care of us. We got our AD that's been taking care of us, and we had the pleasure of meeting the infamous Coach Eddie Robinson Jr. yesterday. So everybody has been just looking after us, our time here in Alabama. We appreciate you all.
Yeah, you heard it from Ms. Bennett. It's so much more than a university. This truly is a community. It is a place unlike any other place on earth, where the vibes are immaculate 24/7. So we've had such a pleasure talking with you. You'll be here the rest of the day.
Yes,
we're looking forward to seeing you. And again, it's not too late now. You can come on down and catch the rest of this game.
Yes.
But we'll see you on the other side for those that aren't able to make it down.